स्टूडेंट्स वेलकम बैक टू ऑल फोर्स मैथ्स क्लास। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन लास्ट सेशन वी हैव स्टार्टेड प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन इंटरसेक्शन लाइंस एंड फैमिली ऑफ कॉन्करेंट लाइंस। नाउ इन दिस सेशन लेट अस कंटिन्यू द प्रॉब्लम्स। ओके, प्लीज स्टार्ट द प्रॉब्लम्स। फर्स्ट वन, इफ 4a प्लस 5b प्लस 6c इज इक्वल 0, 4a plus 5b plus 6c is equal 0, then the set of lines ax plus by plus c is equal 0 are concurrent at a point dash. Already we discussed about this point. Suppose the family of concurrent lines are in this way, lambda 1 l1 plus lambda 2 l2 is equal to 0, or l1 plus lambda l2 is equal to 0. For different values of lambda 1, lambda 2, we get different lines. At the same time, for different values of lambda, we get different lines. Suppose L1, L2 are, these are intersecting lines at P. Then, any line passing through this P is said to be family of concurrent lines. Okay, family of concurrent lines. The point of concurrency is nothing but the point of intersection of the lines L1 is equal to 0 and L2 is equal to 0. Okay, the point of concurrency is nothing but point of intersection of the lines L1 is equal to 0 and L2 is equal to 0. In this case, 4a plus 5b plus 6c is equal to 0. A, B, C are real numbers and they follow the relation 4a plus 5b plus 6c is equal to 0. Then the set of lines ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. That means for different values of a, b, c, we get different lines. All of these lines are concurrent. Now we find the point of concurrency of that lines. Okay, please note this value. What is the relation between A, B, C? First given condition is 4A plus 5B plus 6C is equal to 0. Okay. Now we reduce the value of C in terms of A, B. That means what is the value of 6C? 6C is equal to minus 4A minus 5B. Okay. That means what is the value of C? Minus 4A minus 5B by 6. That implies C is equal to minus 4 by 6 into A minus 5 by 6 into B. Okay, it is the value of C. But the set of lines are AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0. Set of lines are AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0. This equation can be reduced into lambda 1 L1 plus lambda 2 L2 is equal to 0. Then point of concurrency is nothing but point of intersection of the lines L1 is equal to 0 and L2 is equal to 0. Substitute the value of C in this equation, but the set of lines are ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. That means ax plus by plus c means what is the value of c? Minus 4 by 6 into a minus 5 by 6 into b is equal to 0. Here what is the common term? A is the common term. A of x minus 4 by 6 plus b of y minus 5 by 6 is equal to 0. Please observe this value. It is in the form of lambda 1 L1 plus lambda 2 L2 is equal to 0. It is A is a constant, B is a constant. Lambda 1 L1 plus lambda 2 L2 is equal to 0. Point of concurrency is nothing but the point of intersection of the lines L1 is equal to 0 and L2 is equal to 0. What is the value of L1? X minus 4 by 6 is equal to 0. That implies X is equal to 2 by 3. And L2, it is L1. What is the line L2? Y minus 5 by 6 is equal to 0. That implies Y is equal to 5 by 6. Therefore, point of concurrency of that lines is 2 by 3 comma 5 by 6. 2 by 3 comma 5 by 6 is the point of concurrency of that family of lines. Very, very important model. Okay. Please note the note point. It is very, very important point and shortcut method. Suppose the relation between ABC is in this way. Lambda 1 A plus lambda 2 B plus KC is equal to 0. Here, the relation between ABC in this way, the family of lines AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0. It is the family of lines. The point of concurrency is nothing but simply lambda 1 by K comma lambda 2 by K. Please observe this value. The relation between ABC is lambda 1 A plus lambda 2 B plus KC is equal to 0. Here, X coefficient is nothing but lambda 1 by k, that means a coefficient by c coefficient. y coefficient is nothing but b coefficient by c coefficient lambda 2 by k. But from the given here, what is the value? 4a plus 5b plus 6c is equal to 0. By direct formula, what is the formula? Lambda 1. Lambda 1 means 4. Lambda 2 means 5. K means 6. What is the value? Lambda 1 by k comma lambda 2 by k means 4 by 6. That means 2 by 3, 5 by 6. Okay, direct formula. Please note this value. Note point. If lambda 1a plus lambda 2b plus kc is equal to 0, then the set of lines ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 are concurrent at the point lambda 1 by k comma lambda 2 by k. Very, very important. Please write proof also. What is the relation between these values? Lambda 1a plus lambda 2b plus kc is equal to 0. Lambda 1a plus lambda 2b plus kc is equal to 0. That means, what is the value of kc? Minus lambda 1a minus lambda 2b. That means, c is equal to minus lambda 1 by k into a minus lambda 2 by k into b. Move this value k to RHS by k. Split into these values. It is equation number 1. Okay, but the set of lines are ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Replace c by this value. That means ax plus by plus minus lambda 1 by k into a minus lambda 2 by k into b is equal to 0. Here, what is the common term? A is the common term. A of x minus lambda 1 by k plus b of y minus lambda 2 by k is equal to 0. Please observe this value. It is in the form of lambda 1 L1 plus lambda 2 L2 is equal to 0. Family of congruent lines. The point of congruency is nothing but L1 is equal to 0. Point of intersection of the lines L1 is equal to 0 and L2 is equal to 0. What is the L1? This is L1. X minus lambda 1 by k is equal to 0. That means x is equal to lambda 1 by k. Y is equal to lambda 2 by k. Therefore, point of congruency is direct formula. Okay? Lambda 1 by k comma lambda 2 by k. Okay? Next, second one. If ABC are in AP, then the set of lines AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0 are concurrent at dash. Concurrent at dash. Here, ABC are in AP. Given condition is ABC are in AP. If ABC are in AP, what is the condition? B is equal to A plus C by 2 or 2B is equal to A plus C. 2B is equal to A plus C. That means A minus 2B plus C is equal to 0. It is in the form of lambda 1a plus lambda 2b plus kc is equal to 0. What is the value of lambda 1? Lambda 1 is equal to 1. Lambda 2 is equal to minus 2. What is the value of k? K is equal to 1. Here the family of lines are ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. What is the point of concurrency? Lambda 1 by k comma lambda 2 by k. Point of concurrency is equal to lambda 1 by k comma lambda 2 by k. That means 1 by 1 means 1. Next, lambda 2 means minus 2 by 1 means minus 2. The point of congruence is 1 comma minus 2. Or regular method. By using regular method, replace C as, what is the value of C? If you use regular method, C is equal to 2B minus C. Now, the equation AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0 reduced to C means 2B minus C. It can be reduced into A of X minus 1 plus B of y plus 2 is equal to 0. It is in the form of lambda 1 L1 plus lambda 2 L2 is equal to 0. So x is equal to 1, y is equal to minus 2. Okay, please observe that point. Please note this value. Next, third one. If a by root bc is equal to 2 plus root b by c plus root c by b, where a b c greater than 0, then family of lines root a into x plus root b into y plus root c is equal to 0 passes through the point dash. That means these are family of lines. We find the point of congruency. Okay, here what is the relation between a b c? Given condition is a by root b c is equal to 2 plus root b c b by c plus root c by b, and the same time a b c greater than 0. That means they are positive values. Here, what is the LCM? Root B by C means root B by root C. Root C by B means root C by root B. What is the LCM? A by root BC by 1. That means here LCM is root BC. 2 root BC plus root B into root B means root B whole square. Plus root C into root C means root C whole square. Here denominator cancel. Here what is the formula? A square plus B square plus 2AB means A plus B whole square. That means A is equal to root B plus root C whole square. Okay. What is the meaning of A? A is nothing but root A whole square. Move this A value to RHS side. That means what is the value? Root B plus root C whole square minus root A whole square. Please observe this value. It is in the form of A square minus B square. What are the factors for A square minus B square? A plus B into A minus B. Root B plus root C plus root A into root B plus root C minus root A is equal to 0. Okay. A square minus B square is equal to A plus B into A minus B. But here A, B, C are positive value. This is positive value. This is positive value. This is positive value. The sum of the three positive values is always positive. Never be equal to 0. That means this is not equal to 0. This is not equal to 0. That means move this value to RHS. Root B plus root C minus root A is equal to 0. It is the condition. Okay. Root B plus root C minus root A is equal to 0. Now, the family of lines are in the form of root AX plus root BY plus root C is equal to 0. Substitute this value. That means, what is the value of root C? Root C is equal to root A minus root B. Okay. It is equation number 1. But, the family of lines are in the form of root AX plus root BY plus root C is equal to 0. What is the value of root C? It can be replaced as root A minus root B. Next step is root AX plus root BY plus root A minus root B is equal to 0. Here what is the common value? Root A is the common value X minus 1 plus root B is the common value X plus 1. Root AX plus root A means X plus 1. Root B into Y minus 1 is equal to 0. Here it is in the form of lambda 1 L1 plus lambda 2 L2 is equal to 0. Okay. So the point of intersection of the lines is nothing but L1 is equal to 0. Point of intersection of the lines L1 is equal to 0 and L2 is equal to 0. What is L1? X plus 1 is equal to 0. That means X is equal to minus 1, Y is equal to 1. Therefore, the lines, family of lines always passes through the point minus 1 comma 1. Okay. Please note this value. Next, write the node point. The point of intersection of the lines x by a plus y by b is equal to 1 and x by b plus y by a is equal to 1 is ab by a plus b comma ab by a plus b. The point of intersection of the lines x by a plus y by b is equal to 1 and x by b plus y by a is equal to 1 is ab by a plus b comma ab by a plus b. Here what is the first equation? X by a plus y by b is equal to 1. After LCM it can be reduced into bx plus ay minus ab is equal to 0. It is equation number 1. What is the second equation? X by b plus y by a is equal to 1. After LCM it can be reduced into ax plus by minus ab is equal to 0. By solving these two equations by using the cross multiplication method, we get this value. Please find this, prove this value. Okay, next, second one. Let L1 is equal to 0, comma L2 is equal to 0 and L3 is equal to 0 are three concurrent lines. L1 is equal to 0, L2 is equal to 0 and L3 is equal to 0 are three concurrent lines. Then there exist a scalars lambda 1, comma lambda 2 and lambda 3. Then there exist a scalars lambda 1, lambda 2 and lambda 3 such that not all 0 and there exist a scalars lambda 1, lambda 2 and lambda 3 in bracket not all 0 such that lambda 1 into L1 plus lambda 2 into L2 plus lambda 3 into L3 is equal to 0. If these three lines are concurrent, there exist a scalars lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3 such that lambda 1 L1 plus lambda 2 L2 plus lambda 3 L3 is equal to 0. Please observe this point. Suppose L1 is equal to this line, L2 is equal to this line, L3 is this line. All of these are concurrent at P x1 y1. Okay. All of these are concurrent at P x1 y1. That means P x1 y1 lies on the line L1. Say A1x plus B1y plus C1 is equal to 0 be the first line. So x1 y1 lies on this line means a1 x1 plus b1 y1 plus c1 is equal to 0. Similarly, the point P x1 y1 lies on the line 2. That means a2 x1 plus b2 y1 plus c2 is equal to 0. Please observe this value. Second line is a2 x plus b2 y plus c2. Third line is a3 x plus b3 y plus c3. Similarly, this point also lies on the third line. a3 x1 plus b3 y1 plus okay c3 is equal to 0. Here lambda 1 into l1 plus lambda 2 into l2 plus lambda 3 into l3 is equal to 0. Substitute the point P x1 y1 in this equation. L1, substitute the point in L11 means this value. This value is always 0. This value is always 0. This value is always 0. 0 plus 0 plus 0 means 0. Okay? This family of concurrent lines always satisfies this condition. It is very, very important. If L1 is equal to 0, L2 is equal to 0, L3 is equal to 0 or 3 concurrent lines, then there exists a scalar PQ or not all 0 such that lambda 1 into L1 plus lambda 2 into L2 plus lambda 3 into L3 is equal to 0. Okay? Please note this value. Next, fourth one. A straight line with slope 1 passes through Q minus 3 comma 5 and meets the straight line x plus y is equal to 6 at P. Then PQ is equal to dash. Distance between P and Q is dash. Please observe the question. A straight line with the slope 1 passes through Q minus 3 comma 5 and meets the straight line x plus y is equal to 6. Here the line equation is x plus y is equal to 6 means minus 6 is equal to 0. Say it is the line. Okay. Next, another line passes through Q minus 3 comma 5. Q minus 3 comma 5 means this. Minus 3 comma 5 and with slope 1. That means it makes 45 degrees width. It meets the line, this line. What is this line? X plus y minus 6 is equal to 0 at Q. What is the distance from P to Q? In this case, we find the value of Q by solving the lines 1 and 2. What is the equation of the line 1? X plus y minus 6 is equal to 0. It is the line 1. Okay. Next, the inclination of the slope of the line M is equal to 1. Another line, slope of the line is 1. And it passes through the point minus 3 comma 5. If the slope and point are given, what is the equation of the line? Y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. By using that formula, we find this line equation. By solving these two values, we get Q. Now, we find the distance between PQ. That is the one of the method. Alternative method. Already we proved this formula. If the distance from P to the any line is mod AX1 plus BY1 plus C by root over A square plus B square. Distance is nothing but perpendicular distance. The distance from P to this line along a another line which makes an angle theta is nothing but mod AX1 plus BY1 plus C by A cos theta plus B sin theta. It is the direct formula. In this case, the line is x plus y minus 6 is nothing but it is the line AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0. Point P x1 y1 is nothing but minus 3 comma 5. Here, what is the inclination of this line? Slope of the line M is equal to 1. That means theta is equal to, what is that value? 45 degrees. Okay. Say, this value is R. PQ distance is R. By using parametric form, already we proved this value. Okay. This distance PQ is nothing but PQ is equal to mod AX1 plus BY1 plus C by A cos theta plus B sin theta. Okay. Here, AX1 means minus 3. Plus 5 minus 6 by a cos theta means 1 into cos 45. Cos 45 means 1 by root 2 plus 1 into 1 by root 2. Okay. Here 3 plus 5 8. 8 minus 6 means 2 by 1 by root 2 means 2 by 1 by root 2 plus 1 by root 2 means 2 by root 2. That is equal to 2 into root 2 by 2. What is the value? Root 2 units. Okay. The distance of this PQ is nothing but root 2 units. Okay, by using this formula, we find the distance. Our alternative method, by finding the equation of this value and solving these two values, we get Q. Find the distance between the two points. That is also root 2. Okay, please note this value. Next, fifth one. Let L be the line belongs to the family of straight lines A plus 2B into X plus A minus 3B into Y plus a minus 8b is equal to 0, where a comma b belongs to R. It is a passage question, paragraph question. It is a passage. By using this condition, we find these two problems. We solve these two problems. Next, first one. The equation of the line, which is farthest from the point 2, 2 is. the equation of the line which is farthest from the point 2 comma 2 is. The line belongs to this family and farthest from 2 comma 2. Okay, next. The equation of the line which is shortest distance from P 2 comma 2 is. The equation of the line which is shortest distance from P 2 comma 2 is. Okay. Here, what is the family, what is the given family of the lines? A plus 2B of X plus A minus 3B of Y plus A minus 8B is equal to 0, where A comma B are real numbers. It is a family of lines. First, we reduce this value into lambda 1 L1 plus lambda 2 L2 is equal to 0 and find the point of concurrency of that family. Okay, we reduce this value into what is the value AX plus AY plus A. What is the common term? A of X plus Y plus 1. Okay, plus next terms 2BX minus 3BY minus 8B. What is the common term? B is the common term, 2X minus 3Y minus 8 is equal to 0. It is in the form of lambda 1 L1 plus lambda 2 L2 is equal to 0. Okay, it is the family of congruent lines. First, we find the point of congruency of these lines. Suppose this point is A. Now, we find by solving these two values, we find the value of A. Now, the equation of the line which is farthest from 2 comma 2. Say, this point, already we find this value. P is 2 comma 2. Okay, if the line is farthest from P to this line, that means AP is always perpendicular to, greatest distance means it is perpendicular to this value. So, we find that equation. That means, next, the equation of the line which is shortest means, shortest is nothing but the line AP. Already we discussed these conditions. Okay, please note this value. It is in the form of lambda 1 L1 plus lambda 2 L2 is equal to 0. Okay. What is the first line? X plus Y plus 1 is equal to 0. It is the first line. Next line 2X minus 3Y minus 8 is equal to 0. Second line. By elimination method or by using cross multiplication method, solve these values. Suppose multiply equation 1 with 2. First equation into 2, we get 2X plus 2Y plus 2 is equal to 0. Second equation is 2x minus 3y minus 8 is equal to 0. By subtracting 2x, 2x cancel. This value is 5y plus 10 is equal to 0. What is the value of y? Y is equal to minus 2. Y is equal to minus 2. Substitute the value of y is equal to minus 2 in equation 1. We get, put y is equal to minus 2 in 1. We get, what is the value of x? X minus 2 plus 1 means x minus 1 is equal to 0, x is equal to 1. Therefore, point of intersection is 1 comma minus 2. Please observe this value. Point of intersection, say this value is A. Point of intersection of this family of lines is A is equal to 1 comma minus 2. Please note this value. Next, first question. First one, these are the family of lines, all of these are intersecting at the point A, 1 comma minus 2. P is the given point, P 2 comma 2. Required line is farthest distance from A, from P and passing through A. Required line always belongs to the family of these lines. That means the line passes through this point. So, required line is greatest distance means the line is perpendicular to AP. It is the required line. Now we find the equation of the line L. Please note this value. First one, since the required line is farthest distance from or farthest from the point P2 comma 2. That is, it is perpendicular to the line AP. What is the slope of AP? Slope of AP is equal to y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. 2 minus of minus 2 means 4 by, please observe this value, by 2 minus 1 means 1. That is equal to 4 by 1. What is the perpendicular slope? This is the slope of the line AP. Required line is perpendicular to this value. Required line perpendicular. Therefore, slope of the required line is equal to minus 1 by 4. Slope of the required line is minus 1 by 4. And this line always passes through the point 1 comma minus 2. Here, m is equal to required line slope, m is equal to minus 1 by 4. And point x1, y1 on the line is 2, 1 comma minus 2. Required line is passes through the point of concurrency of that lines. Since the line belongs to this family. Okay, x1, y1 is equal to 1 comma minus 2. If a minus a by b is the slope, what is the equation of the line? Ax plus by is equal to ax1 plus by1. Equation of the line. is x plus 4y is equal to x1 plus 4y1. X1 means 1, y1 means minus 2. What is the value? X plus 4y is equal to 1 minus 8. That means minus 7. So final answer is x plus 4y plus 7 is equal to 0. X plus 4y plus 7 is equal to 0 is the required equation of the line which is farthest from the point 2 comma 2. Very, very important. Next, second one. The equation of the line which is shortest distance. Shortest distance is nothing but the line passes through the point P. Shortest distance is 0. 0 means the line passes through P. So, the equation of the line which is shortest distance is nothing but equation of the line AP. Please note the second point. Since the line has shortest distance from P, therefore, required line is nothing but line AP. Already we find the slope of AP. Again, you find the slope of AP. Slope of the required line is nothing but slope of AP. M is equal to y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1 means 4 by what is the value? 4 by 1. That is equal to 4. Point is this line passes through both points. So 1 comma minus. So substitute that point. 4 by 1. That means 4x minus y. Equation of the line. A by B slope. Ax minus By is equal to 4x1 minus y1. 4x minus y is equal to 4 plus 2. That means 4x minus y minus 6 is equal to 0. Or by using two points form, y minus y1 by y2 minus y1 is equal to x minus x1 by x2 minus x1. By using that formula also, we find the equation of the line PA. Okay, please note this value. Next, sixth one. If two parallel lines makes intercepts P and Q, small p and small q, on x and y axis respectively, then the distance between them is dash. In this case, two parallel lines makes intercepts P and Q on x and y axis. Suppose this is the x axis, y axis, x, x dash, y, y dash. Here two parallel lines are given. This is one of the parallel line, this is another parallel line. These two are parallel. The distance between two parallel lines is always constant. Okay? Here, parallel lines makes intercepts P and Q on the X and Y axis means, what is the meaning of X intercepts? This line cuts at A, AB, this line is AB, this line is CD. Say, the first line is AB and second line is CD. The distance between these two values is nothing but intercept made by these lines on the X axis. That means, this length is P. Not x intercept means here x by a plus y by b is equal to 1, a is x intercept, b is y intercept. Here the intercept is different. It is the distance between these two intersection points. Okay, it is P. Next, what is the value of Q? This is the Q. Y intercept means this is Q. These two values are given. Next, what is the distance between these two parallel lines? Now we find the distance between these two parallel lines. Please observe this value. It is the origin. It is the vertical line. Please draw one of the line vertical to this value. Please draw one of the vertical line at A to X axis. Okay. It is nothing but. Please observe this value. These two are parallel. These two are parallel. That means it is a parallelogram. That means it is. What is the length of this value? Q. That means this length also Q units. Please observe this value. Let it is AC D. Say this value is E. Okay. Here A, E, D, B is a parallelogram. So this value is equal to this value. It is nothing but Q. So this value is Q. By using these two values, we find the distance between these two parallel lines. Suppose I draw a perpendicular line M. Perpendicular line M. This AM is nothing but distance between two parallel lines. This AM is nothing but distance between two parallel lines. Okay? Please note the diagram. Draw the diagram. Please draw the diagram. Okay? From the triangle ACE. From the triangle ACE, what are the values of this value? AC is P, AE is Q. The angle between these two values is nothing but 90 degrees. This is a right angle triangle. Area of triangle ACE is equal to half into base into height. That means PQ. Any doubt in this equation? Any doubt in this equation? Here, CE is equal to right angle triangle. This value is root over P square plus Q square. By using Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse square is equal to side square plus side square. Suppose it is the base, it is nothing but height. Height is nothing but distance between two parallel lines. By using that property, again area of triangle AC is equal to half into CE into H. H is nothing but distance between the parallel lines. half into what is the value of CE? Root over P square plus Q square into H. By equating these two are areas of the triangle. By equating these two values, we get the value of H. Half PQ is equal to half into root over P square plus Q square into H. Half of cancel. What is the H value? H is equal to PQ by root over P square plus Q square. It is the distance between two parallel lines. Very, very, very important. Please note this value. Very, very, very important. Okay?